What's up, my green screen and PD peeps? Thanks for choosing this video to learn some tantalizing tips and tricks using PowerDirector. If you use PowerDirector and you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider clicking the subscribe button and clicking the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. Green screens are a Hollywood staple for pulling off dope special effects, and with PowerDirector, you can use the chroma key tool to make cray-cray effects with just a few screen taps. The first magnificent trick I'm going to show you is the Land of Oz effect. The Land of Oz effect makes it seem that you're passing through a door or a keyhole from one world to a different world. You'll need green screen footage of a door opening and the footage that you want to show once you go through the door. Place the footage that you want to show through the door on the main track and place the footage of the door opening on the overlay track. Make sure that you pinch out on the footage so that it fills in the screen. Then you want to move your playhead to a position where you can see the green. And you want to tap on the clip on the overlay track. Then you want to tap on chroma key, tap the eyedropper, tap the green, and tap back. Next, you want to make the footage look completely black and white so that you can go from a black and white world to a color world. So you want to go ahead and tap on effects. And then you want to go to find filter color green. Tap on that. And what that'll do is it'll make everything black and white except the portion that was green. And we don't want the portion that was green to be changed to black and white because it'll remove the chroma key effect. Then you want to tap on back. And you can go ahead and play this back. Now, you're off to see the wizard. The next wonderific trick is the X-ray effect. The X-ray effect makes it look like you can do X-rays using your smartphone. You need a picture of an X-ray hand, and you need a video of a smartphone with a picture that's all green. Then you want to record yourself waving the smartphone with the green picture over your hand. You're going to go ahead and place the footage of the X-ray hand on one of the overlay tracks. And then you want to place the phone footage on another overlay track underneath the X-ray hand. Make sure you pinch out on the footage of the phone to make it fill in the screen. Then you want to go ahead and tap on the phone footage. And you want to tap opacity. And you want to make your opacity 50% or less. And that way we can go ahead and see the X-ray hand. Then you can go ahead and tap back. Then you want to tap on the picture of the X-ray hand and you want to pinch out to resize it and use the rotation to put it right over the hand wherever you need it. Once you got the hand where you want it, you want to go ahead and tap on the phone footage again and you want to tap on opacity again. You want to change that back to 100%. Then you need to move your playhead to a position where you can see the green on the phone. And you want to go ahead and tap on the phone footage, tap chroma key, tap the eyedropper, and then tap the green. And you may need to make some adjustments to the color range or the denoise on this one. You can tap back. And you can play it back.
Get your lead vest ready. It's time for some X-rays.
If you want to see the full tutorial of this effect, there's a link in the video description. The next trick is the parallax effect. This effect creates a video from a photo while adding a simultaneous pan and zoom, which creates a cool looking 3D motion effect. You need a picture and you're going to need a photo app like PhotoDirector to create two pictures from that single picture. From that single picture, you're going to create a foreground picture with green and a background picture. What you want to do is place the footage that you want to move sideways on one of the overlay tracks. Then you want to go ahead and tap on that footage and you want to tap on transform keyframe. Then you want to resize your footage, make it a little bit bigger so it fills up the screen. The reason why you want to do that is so that you can move it across the screen. So at this point, you want to go ahead and move your footage all the way to the left. And then you want to go ahead and tap on the create a keyframe button. It'll place a keyframe right there. Then you want to move your playhead to the end of the footage. And you want to drag your footage all the way over to the other side. And it should automatically create a keyframe right there. You want to tap on back. And you can tap on back. Then you want to move your playhead back to the beginning of the clip. And you want to place the footage with the green on another overlay track. So you want to go ahead and tap on overlay. Go to the location where the photo is. Tap that photo and tap the plus sign. And it'll go ahead and add it. You can tap back and tap back again. Now you can go ahead and tap on that footage and you can resize it so it fills out the screen by pinching out. And then you want to go ahead and tap on chroma key. Tap on the eyedropper and tap the green. I'm going to tap back. And then you want to tap on transform keyframe. And for the first keyframe, you want it to just be right where it is. So you can go ahead and tap on create keyframe. Then move your playhead to the end of the footage. And you want to go ahead and pinch out to scale it up. And you can tap back. Tap back again. And go ahead and tap on play. I like to move it. If you want to see the full tutorial for this effect, there's another link in the video description. Now, it's time to break down the invisible cloak effect. This effect makes it seem that a cloak can make whoever wears it invisible. You need a green screen to use as a cloak, and you need a different colored sheet to place inside of the green screen so you can actually see the cloak. You need to shoot the scene with the talent covering him or herself with the cloak, and you need to shoot the scene with no one in it. Make sure that the camera is on a tripod and make sure that it's in the exact same place when you shoot both of those scenes. You want to place the clip with nothing in it on the main track. And you want to place the clip with the talent and the green screen on an overlay track. You want to go ahead and pinch out on that overlay footage so that it fills the screen. You want to move your playhead to a position where you can see the green screen has covered the talent. Then you want to tap on that footage and you want to tap on chroma key and tap the eyedropper tool and tap on the green. And you may need to change your color range and your denoise on this one. You want to tap back and you want it to fade out at the end because you can still see a little green line around it. So tap on fade and tap on fade out and you can tap back and you can play this back. Hocus pocus. If you want to see the full tutorial, guess what? There's a link in the video description. Last but not least, we have the like, subscribe, and bell button effect. This creates a call out that you can use on all of your YouTube videos. You can download or screen record a subscribe, like, and bell animation with the green screen background from a bunch of different YouTube channels. Just make sure that you have permission from the creator to use the content commercially for free before you use it. You want to go ahead and place your footage that you're going to have on the main track. And then you want to place the green screen footage on an overlay track. You want to move the playhead to a position where you can see the call out happening. And you want to tap on the footage and you want to go ahead and resize it and position it, place it where you want it to show up on the screen when the call out appears. Then you want to go ahead and tap on chroma key. You want to tap on the eyedropper, tap on the green, tap back. You can move your playhead to the beginning and hit play. Now, everybody gonna click subscribe, like, and hit that bell when they watch your videos. If you don't own the app and you like what you see, I'll leave my affiliate link to try Power Director in the video description. Using it helps support the channel so I can make more content for you. I know you want more Power Director love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.